Several initiatives have been done by the government, stakeholders, international NGOs in attempts to address food security.
Yes.
But still, people are going hungry in Northeastern Kenya. People are going hungry in most of their sub-regions. What can be, what options do they have? Do we have as Kenya?
Yes. This is a problem, I think, which is as old as Kenya, because successive governments, one after the other, come and we have, you know, people in the arid regions facing, you know, food shortages. In my view, I think, you know, we should also look at it differently instead of just saying that it's an issue with the government and the government, you know, taking full blame. The way also the way these people, especially the pastoralists, are socialized, you know, their lifestyles also some to some extent contribute to, you know, the food shortages that they have. So in my view, it's not a problem that would be solved, you know, very quickly. But you know, non-governmental organizations and even the government itself should, you know, start slowly in terms of changing the way, you know, people are socialized. Just the same way, for instance, we people took an affirmative action against female genital mutilation and came to an end, or is, you know, really practiced, the same affirmative action should be taken, you know, in such areas, so that somebody does not die together with their, you know, livestock there. One is able to know that, you know, when I'm hungry, I'm able to sell my cow or my camel and get food. And the other thing is the leadership that is elected there should also be able to, you know, especially meet together and even, you know, talk about these issues really loudly, so that even if it means more funds allocated or you know, special recommendations taken up to deal with this, because I believe when they are campaigning, that is one of the agenda, saying that they are going to deal probably with hunger. So why not take that up subsequently after election? It's very bad, it's very dehumanizing for people to die without food in this modern day Kenya. So if people really work together, then we'll have a better country.
In Isiolo, still a personal community. Some communities in rural Isiolo, I'll tell you if I remember the name. But the youth are shifting from pastoralism to modern agriculture, to farming. I remember the Isiolo River. I was happy when I saw some youth use that water to embrace irrigation, do some little farming, which initially was meant to produce crop for their family household. But family livelihood. But again, now they're producing more. They want to sell to the supermarket for other people to buy. How can such like initiative, more of such initiative, be adopted or be encouraged?
Yes, when you look at Isiolo, you will see you know, various players taking a deliberate initiatives to be able to, you know, ensure that the youth in those regions are emancipated from, you know, their previous ways to the modern ways, and you are able to see a very good change. So I think a lot of concerted efforts from non-governmental organizations to the county governments and even the national government, you know, helps change. But again, you know, there are all these challenges about, you know, what are individual plans? Are people really committed to bringing about change, or is it just lip service? So at the end of the day, it all goes down to how good a plan is and how well it is implemented. So if we have youth, like we said, trained, if we have the right agricultural practices that are relevant to those areas introduced there, we will have change happening. But if we are not committed to bringing change, we will always have these problems again and again, year in, year out, always talking about the shortage of food and all these other issues.
At Takamoto,
yes.
Do you give opportunities to the...
Yes, at Takamoto Biogas, like we said, we are the leading biogas provider in the country, and a lot of youth come by us for internships. Being able at the end of the day to build biogas digesters or biogas systems, and they are also able to pass on that knowledge to other people. We also provide biogas related information to the youth. There are people today in universities who are studying about renewable energy as a degree course or as a diploma course. So they become our interns, and they are able to get practical knowledge, serve people at the community level. There are other opportunities that come from biogas, like for example, even selling biogas appliances. And like I said, there are many biogas related appliances, such as water heaters. We have brooders, we have gas burners, desulfurizers. All these contribute to the the chain, of the biogas chain, and they provide opportunities for young people to earn livelihoods from all that. So Takamoto Biogas provides opportunities for youth to become technicians, agents. They can become agents, our agents, and at the end of the day, are able to earn livelihoods from Takamoto Biogas.
We need to wind up, but let's touch a bit on the exports market, especially for the fresh produce.
Yes.
There have been issues that Kenyan exports face a lot of quality standards challenges in the exports market.
Yes.
First, are there standards in the quality standards, and if there are so, how comes in Kenya? What has Kenya not done that makes our goods to face a great challenge to compete?
I think because of what some commentators allude to is that disparity between different countries when it comes to trade, that when we are importing our products to certain countries, we face a lot of conditions as opposed to those developed countries bringing products to us. In my view, even as we meet those standards, I think that is also a question, is a diplomatic question. How good are we in negotiating? Because trade agreements are a product of negotiation. So how good we negotiate is also a very important factor to consider. Because when we sit on the negotiating table and we agree to all these conditions, and we also don't give conditions, you see now that brings that disparity. It sounds easy, and maybe I'm being a bit too simplistic, but I think when the proper effort is put in negotiating proper trade agreements, at the end of the day, we'll be able to have a balance. The other thing is also open ourselves, and of course the government is doing a very good job in terms of reaching out to very many markets, so that we are not, you know, just victims of, you know, certain jurisdictions giving us permissions, that we have, you know, bigger markets. And we, if as a country we are able to position ourselves, because even those developed countries, they come together as blocks so that they can be able to have bigger markets. And that is the way to go in the world today.
So, we wind up.
Yes.
Your parting shot.
My parting shot is that, again, there's a lot of information out there that is relevant to agriculture. Farmers TV, for instance, is a television, is a media house that basically means, deals with farming or agricultural related activities. Let us get the right information, let us talk to the right people, let us talk about agriculture. Thank you.
If somebody is hearing of Takamoto today for the first time,
yes,
how can they reach you?
Yes, if someone is hearing about Takamoto Biogas for the first time today, Takamoto Biogas is a company that deals with biogas, installation of biogas, and biogas related appliances. We have an active website, www.takamotobiogas.com. We have an active Facebook page. You can also reach us at 0736 892 391. Our costs are very competitive. We also give you warranty, so that at the end of the day, because of wear and tear, we are able to maintain our system. I keep on pointing that out, because that is one of the biggest challenges facing people wanting biogas installed for them today. You install a biogas system, and then when it comes to maintenance, the technician is nowhere to be seen. So we are very keen to offer you warranty so that you enjoy value for your money. Our number still remains 0736 892 391. You can reach us at Naivas Building, Githunguri, third floor. Githunguri is in Kiambu, third floor. And we'll be there to at your service.
That was great. Thank you so much for coming into the show. We come to the end of the show. My name is Malachi Montano, who have been your host, and I was joined by Kelvin Gitata, an agri business analyst, expert consultant. But the pleasure is only that all this information can only be found on Farmers TV,
the Farmers Partner.